Hey guys, Ashley here with Country Roots Farm. So we have been talking about how we are going to cross the creek that's caused by the natural spring and runoff that comes together, and it's through the middle of our property. So we really need a way to get across it without disrupting it. Been kind of going between, do we want a bridge or do we want to put in a culvert and do like the dirt over the culvert to cross that would look really natural? And we just haven't really been able to decide what to do, but we have been praying for open doors and closed doors. And so for open doors to show us the way that God wants us to go, and then closed doors obviously the way that we don't want to go. So we were on the way home today and we're driving through our little town and we passed this house that's been there forever, and they had this culvert and they're kind of like up a hill. And I was like, oh my gosh, Austin, they have a culvert in their yard for sale. And he was like, yeah, okay. And he at first was not even going to turn around. I was like, no, they have a culvert for sale in their front yard. We got to go get it. And he was like, okay. So he turned around and we're parked in like the median to turn into their house. And he's like, how do you even know it's for sale? Like, there's nothing on it. And I was like, yeah, there's like a white paper flying in the wind. Like, that's probably says for sale or its instructions, but let's check it out and see if it's for sale. It's sitting by the road. And so we pull in and it was for sale. And I'm currently sitting on it because I'm so excited. That was the little white paper. If I can point to it right there. See? And so I was like, it's for sale, and it was only $30. So I measured it. It's almost nine feet long, and it's the 15 inch diameter. So a culvert this size would probably be $200 or so. And we just got this thing for $30. Like, what in the world? I'm so excited. I can't wait to install it. And you guys stay tuned so you can see how we do that. Thanks for watching. Today we are marking out the trail or path that we're gonna use to put in the culvert to cross the creek down there. So obviously the woods are pretty thick here. There is a lot of baby trees though. Like, look at this baby tree beside me. Does this qualify as a tree? There are a bunch of baby trees, and we have a forestry mulcher coming out here in a few days to cut up and mulch all of the trees that we've dropped. I can't wait to show you guys the progress that we've made, and he's gonna cut us the trail to put the culvert for the creek. The timing of getting this culvert and already having the forestry mulcher scheduled to come out in a few days is so perfect, because we just added on this project to what we already wanted done.
And he is able to get in here and really just grind up all these trees so much faster than we were able to. We would have spent many, many weekends working to clear this area. It is full of vines and so many small trees. You can barely walk through here, and he can just go in and grind them down to nothing. With just a little work from the forestry mulcher, we were able to then drive our tractor back to this area that we could barely walk in before. And then we're carrying the culvert in because it's too wide for the trail and it's really lightweight, so it wasn't hard to do at all to carry it back there. And even though it's lightweight, it supports a lot of weight once you get dirt on it, so you can drive across it or anything. We did have some more trees to clear that were kind of on the bank of the creek that the forestry mulcher couldn't get to, or that we would have spent a lot more time trying to get to it. So we just marked out the area that we wanted him to go, and then we were going to clear these by hand anyway. So we got them out of the way quickly. After getting all the trees out of the way, of course, we need to get a good area for the culvert to sit. So Austin used the tractor to kind of dig a little flat area out that the culvert can fit in between the two banks, because it's not very big, the creek right here. It's pretty small. And I don't know if it's more runoff in this area or what it is, because it doesn't even flow all year, but we didn't want to risk disturbing it. And we're ready to drop the culvert in. The next step will be to pile dirt on top of this culvert, and thank goodness we have a tractor and we're not trying to do this shovel after shovel. After dumping the first load, I'm kind of getting caught in the briars back there, but after putting the first load on the culvert, I saw it kind of just move out of the way and the dirt went underneath it, so I took a shovel and kind of buried it beside the culvert to hold it in place, and we got a shovel on both sides to do that. After quite a few more loads of dirt, the bridge is complete. The water is already flowing through it. We compacted it using the shovels and just hitting the dirt, and then also doing the same thing to the sides to just create that good mound. And then we're gonna drive the tractor over it several times to really make sure that it's nice and hard compacted. This will be the first full drive over the bridge.
Glance. Look at this. Look across the. There's our bridge. Obviously, he's coming back to the other side to grind some of this stuff up. So here's our culvert right here in front of me. None of this existed this morning. So much progress has been made in just a few hours. It is absolutely amazing. I don't know if you remember when we were building this that you couldn't even stand in this area, and when I tried to cross, I was torn up with briars, and now look at it. So much room. everywhere. Obviously, we got to clear out the creek. It's actually running through here. You just can't see it. But I am so impressed and so excited.
Now, a few months have passed since we put in the culvert. It has been so convenient to be able to drive the tractor to the other side. And there's grass growing everywhere in here now. And it's just such a beautiful area. We plan on putting a little prayer garden down here by the creek.
The little creek isn't flowing right now. It's been a couple of months since we put the culvert in. We've driven over it a bunch of times in four-wheelers and a golf cart and our tractor, and it's held up amazingly. All of this grass in the area that we cleared just filled in. We didn't plant any of this, but it is so pretty and lush, and the deer are walking over our culvert too. It just makes this cute little area. And we're super excited that it worked, that it's holding. We haven't had any problems with it. We haven't had a lot of rain, so there hasn't been a lot of water flowing through it. So we'll see as time continues, see how it holds up against the current, whenever there is a current. But we're super excited, so thanks for following along. Please like and subscribe if you want to continue to see us turn this raw land into a homestead and farm. Thanks for watching.